గురుభ్యో నమః. హరి ఓం. శ్రీపురాణానాం ఆలయం కరుణాలయం నమగవత్పాద శంకరం లోకశంకరం శంకరం శంకరాచార్యం కేశవం పాదరాయణం సూత్రకృతౌ వందే భగవంతౌ పునఃపునః గురురాత్మేతి మూర్తిభేద విభాగినే వ్యోమవ్యాప్తదేహాయ దక్షిణామూర్తయే నమః. టుడే ఇస్ ది స్వామీజీస్ ఫస్ట్ సాధనా డే. సో టు పూజ్య స్వామిజీ టు షో అవర్ టు పూజ్య స్వామిజీ వి హ్యావ్ ఫైవ్ ఆన్ సాధుస్ లైఫ్ అండ్ పోస్ట్ బై ఆది శంకరాచార్య నేమ్ కౌపీ పంచకం. పంచకం ఫైవ్ వర్సెస్. కౌపీ ఇస్ క్లాత్ క్లాత్ వన్ వేర్స్ అస్ అన్ కౌపీనం కౌ పంచకం ది ఫైవ్ ఆన్ కౌపీనం. యాక్చువల్లీ ఇట్స్ నాట్ ఫైవ్ ఆన్ కౌపీనం. కౌ అంతః ఇస్ వాట్ ఇస్ బి వన్ హూస్ వేర్ కౌపీనం. Look at the first verse. Veda vakyeshu sadaramantaha vikshanna matrena chatushtimantaha visokamantakkarane charantaha kopivantakkalu bhagyavantaha. So all this in kopinavantakkalu bhagyavantaha. The verse where a loin cloth is think, oh, then we wear a tant extra in his underwear, so we should go for only loin cloth. In fact, there has been people who used, I have read books, it is written that, you know, one has to only wear a loin cloth, and because he says, you know, the one who wears that only is the Bhagyavan, and that's not the intent. It's like Pooja Swamiji says, Kaupeena Vantakalu Bhagyavantaha. So even if only a loin cloth, more than that, he doesn't have any other possessions, he doesn't have any other, you know, lucrative dresses or a house or a shelter or, you know, so much of wealth, all one loin cloth, they are blessed. So that is this whole thing. So that's why this Kaupeena Panchakam at significance, because it great promise. So you don't need to have anything. All you just, even you just have a loin cloth, yes. But then, because somebody has only a loin cloth, doesn't make the person blessed, right? So there is something else, if not in terms of assets, what which makes one a blessed person, despite longings, is what is addressed in this verse. So essentially it is describing what is a sadhu's life. A sadhu, a sannyasi, the one who is a renunciate, one who renunciate as in mentally as renounced, right? It's not necessary the person. So can be blessed with just Kaupeena. The person can be blessed even with some more dresses on or sitting in a car. It doesn't matter, because just adding a few more things in. So the problem is not in having all this, and not having all this is not going to solve your problem. But to solve the problem without having any of this. So having all these things are not any more problem for. So that's what is the intent. So forget about all these worldly things, right? About great set of dresses or tools and the houses and the riches that you can have. Without this, even if you just have a loin cloth, blessed, you still can be happy. And how this being happy without all this is what is addressed in the Torah. So the first one. వేదాంత వాక్యేషు సదారమంతః That's how it starts. Very beautiful. Because nowadays, who is the right guru for you? Who is the best? There are so many gurus around, right? So is this pranayama, someone teaches that yoga, someone teaches something else. So how do you even recognize a person? Who is this? Even if not a guru, is a sadhu, is a good sadhu, right? You need to know. So the question and the only qualification by which one starts looking for somebody, for example, is Ramanam. Tasyantaha Vedantaha, the ending portion of Veda, which talks about a subject matter which is slightly different from the earlier portions of Veda. That's why we separate it as Vedanta, because subject matter of this Vedanta is Brahmavastu. The truth, the truth of oneself, the truth of the God is what is revealed in these sentences, Vedanta Vakya, in which also have these Mahavakyas. And these in the person is always dwelling, always enjoying, at ease with, is at comfort with, is nonsense, consonance with, right? Santaha Ramate means the one who is enjoying, who is resting in it. That's why and all these words, Ramate, the one who is resting in what? Vedanta Vakyeshu. So, Vedanta means Vedanta Vakyarteshu. Not that repeating the sentences, Tattvamasi, Tattvamasi, it's not that. It's like, what is the intent, what is the vision provided by the Vedanta? Is what is the focus of the person, right? That is where the person is remaining engrossed in. That is Vedanta Vakyeshu. So there are two types of sadhus that we speak about. Vidvanyasi, Vividisha Sanyasi. Vidwan is one who already has this jnana, the will is already there. So the one is able to just relax in that jnana which has been provided by Vedanta Vakya. Then Vividha Sanyasi, the one who wants to know Veditu Nicha Vividisha. So the one who wants to learn about it, one who is on the pursuit. So they could be going through Shravanam, may be going for learning from a guru, listening to it, or might have listened and is doing Mananam, where the person is clarifying these visions which are coming up on this Jnanam, or is doing Nididhyasanam, or all three together. So somebody who is still not a Vidwan, but is going through that route is called a Vividisha Sanyasi. So even that person focuses on the Vakya. The Vedanta Vakya is the source of all the whole pursuit. So Vedanta Vakyeshu Sadharamantaha, and that is the primary definition of a sadhu. Now this is there, then all the other things that he is going to describe in the next, and including this verse, next five verses, is on the basis of Vedanta Vakya Ramanam. In engrossed in Vedanta Vakya and Bhiksha Namatrena Tushti Mantha, the chat is there, and a person is with whatever one gets, any food that one gets, right? It's Bhiksha Namatreshu Tushti Mantha, Bhiksha Namatrena Tushti Mantha, the one who is happy with whatever one gets, whether it is food or dress or shelter or whatever. The person just happy with what one gets, right? That is Tushti Mantha. So Tushti means Santosha, happiness. One is that with Anna Matra, what one gets, not going after things, but Vishu Antakarane Charantaha, because one way is dwelling in this Vedanta Vakya, any other life, Vishanna Matrena Tushti Mantaha, the person not in a where one needs something. The person is not feeling shocked or anything. Because Jnanam, that one is a Purna Swarupa, there is no inhibitor in terms of I need this for me to be, I need this to be fulfilled for complete. Right? Sense of incompleteness doesn't exist. So because sense of incompleteness doesn't exist, happy with oneself. Right? Kam antahkarane charantaha, without any unhappiness. So how does unhappiness come? This comes because one has to get something is inadequate without having it, right? Or one loses something again without which one feels incomplete, right? Or which one not happy about, right? Which doesn't make one happy, right? So one gets something which they are not happy about, right? So this is what is called raga dvesha, right? I am trying to change my situations in a way that I can, that, you know, at ease with things, right? And, but though I'm changing the ecosystem around me, it is possible, but despite all these changes, I still feel incomplete. So that's the human predicament, because able to completely be at ease with oneself, right? So, and that is what keeps one in a shoka after things. Antahkarane charantaha. For this person, because of Vedanta Vakya Shravanam and Vedanta Vakya Ramanam, so one feet is not after things which will make him incomplete. So, Vishokam Antahkarane charantaha, Kaupeenantavopi Kalu Bhagyavantaha. Even if that person is wearing a lion cloth, they are blessed. So that's the first verse. Mulam taro kevalamashrayantaha panidvayam bhoktumamantrayantaha kantamiva srim apikuchantaha inavantakkalubhagyavantaha kevalam ashrayantaha. Ashrayanam means the fish. Taro kevalam, a single tree. Mulam ashrayantaha. One who is the roots, a single tree, that's for him or her, he's happy, right? There's a story, right, when just some sadhu is lying on the banks of a river, comes and says, what are you doing here? Right? Person says, yeah, I'm just relaxing. I have nothing to do, so I'm relaxing. So the story says, what is the use of, you know, you have to do work. So don't all this time lying on the banks of the river and that's good. So what are you doing? So I'm a farmer, so take care of. Okay, so you do like this, build a big house. Okay, you'll get married, then you'll get some kids. Okay, good. And then yearning, I'll give my kids all the wealth. Right, I get married off, leave enough wealth for my wife. Okay. Then I just lie down and I'll just relax that I've achieved everything in my life. I'm happy. I just relax. So this says, whatever you are saying you will do after 25 years is what I'm to do. I'm happy with what I have. Go through all that to be happy. My end goal without doing all those, right? So that's so it's has is achieved as in the wealth acquired or get settled or whatever. And those needs to be done. I'm not dismissing that. But once relaxation and peace, it's not about achieving. See, the achievement of those gives certain peace because you are under pressure, that without that you won't be complete. So that gets released and you're happy, right? It's not achievement of that, it's the removal of the pressure, right? It is anxiety of getting there is what is actually stopping you completeness, right? Because you think you are incomplete with all that. That self-judgment is where the problem is, right? The whole problem centers around one self-judgment, one's ability to understand one's true nature, right? And that is the ajnana, right? That ajnana nivritti is what happens through Vedanta Vakya, and that Vakya releases one from the ignorance and recognize the true self with us, which is on the Swarupa, which we will see a little later. So, Mantaro Kevalam Ashrayantaha Panyam Bhoktu Mantrayantaha. Just happy with a meager food which can be held into, you know. Long dishes, right? That's not what it's, whatever keeps filled is what, right? It's all about, like Vivekananda, Swami Vivekananda says, what, how much ever necessary for you. So if something is a necessity, that means you are bound. Cell phone is a necessity to me. It's not a luxury sometime back, but now it's a necessity, right? More is a necessity. I cannot live without it. So if a television is a necessity, a computer is a necessity, a family is a necessity, right? So as and when I have so many of these necessities, it means I'm born without it, I'm fish out of tank water, right? Things which are necessity are move towards them becoming luxury, the better. That's what Swami Vivekananda says, right? So it's that I'm incomplete without all those, right? And a sort of inadequacy, right? With acquiring something is when I can be happy about it. I'm limited. And that happiness going, and a person always feels inadequate, and there is a pressure to get something by hook or crook at many times, and that leads to guilt, that leads to hurt. That's the cause of the whole problem, right? And with all this, a person who is fulfilled, these things, a person can become fulfilled, wherein that the man of limitation itself is false. Any luxury, right? Any want is eating that I don't even need, right? A stone which I used to play earlier, right? A pebble, right? I used to play these pebbles in childhood. Now, I mean, I don't mind having it, but it's not that I feel incomplete without having it, right? At one point in time, and I always used to count it. Do I have all the 10 that I started my day with? Right? So important, right? So now I have grown out of the whole thing, but I don't need that to be complete, right? That is the state of a sadhu. That's why the person is not worried about not having something. Swave parittimantaha sushantarvendriya vrittimantaha aham brahma sukeramantaha kaupeenah kalu bhagyavantaha. After any of these pursuits, then what is a person after, right? I mean, you have to have something in your mind. It's not that you are a piece of log, a loaf of wood, right? But you are One is a conscious person, that is, life exists. So what is that you're minding on, right? A sadhu's mind is resting on. Swabhave paritushti mantaha. Swandabhavaha. What is my own true nature? What is that I recognize as my I? Is this the limited person? Or is this Rupa unlimited, uninhibited? Inhibited Swarupa, the one which is not bound by anything, neither space nor time or the objects which are there. And every object, the space and time is nothing but this one Swarupa of my Dananda. In this relation, Swananda Bhave Paritushti Mantaha Anta Sarvendriya Vritti Mantaha. All the senses means what? No problem. Indriyani Indriyarteshu Vartante Iti Matma Sajjate Bhagavad Gita. So Diya has to dwell in its own object. Next, right? The eye has to see a form, right? Ear has to hear sound, whether you are a jnani or not. Right? Indriyas always, they just do their job. So the problem is with the mind, right? The mind which is operating. It means on the inputs received from the senses and the conclusions when they are centered on I and the way our I am sensing the problems, right? And being care by the problem, that's part of the problem. They are sharp, doing their job and not disturbed by another in-law. So, Sushanta Sarvendriya Vrittimanta Brahma Sukhe Ramanta Brahma Saha. So, Swananda Bhave Paritushtamanta Aharnisham Brahma Sukhe Ramanta. Both are kind of same. Brahma and Swaya are no different, right? Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma says Upanishad. Anta Surupa Anyap Surupa, one's own conscious awareness is at the same Brahman. So the Aharnisham Brahmantaha, there is no as to person is being on Brahman, right? Because Brahman being the Surupa, one's own self, always in the Brahman. Kalu Bhagyavantaha. Such a person engrossed in this Brahman, even is having only Kaupeena, they are Devam Parivartayantaha Swanam Atmani Avalokayantaha Nantyam Nabahismarantaha Kontakkalu Bhagyavantaha Devam Parivartayantaha Devadi, the bondwords, body. All this. So from body onwards, so we start counting from body, right? My first conclusion about who I am, this body, starts with that. In this mind, that's where I identify myself, my emotions. Even my reality is in terms of the mind. And my prana, my breath. These are the things, right, on which I keep dwelling. Atmani avalokayantaha. Atmani swatmanam avalokayantaha. My swasarupa is where this is recognized, right? The swasarupa is where the eye is located. So I don't look at racial divides, inside, this is outside, this is outside and in between, spatiality, which is cognitive. The spatiality rests on omniscience, on the nature is. Before, after a time, on time, all post on Mesa Surupa, which we will see all that in some of the other sessions. But here in Panchakam, he says there is no enough Antam Madhyam Bhai. Sutan is not worried as inside or outside or space. So the Bhai crossed in the Ananta Surupa. Even if the person is just having a loin cloth, because the world, nothing which is separated from that person. There is required the thing which limits so complete. The last Dharam Pavana Mucharantaha Mahamasniti Vibhavayantaha Dikshu Paribhramantaha Kautakalubhagyavantaha Pavam Uttaha Brahmani Dikshu Paribhramantaha Kaupeenavantah Kalu Bhagyavantah Akam Brahma Pavacharantaha. The Akam which is Brahma, Dikshu Brahmavanam Uccharantaha, the one who Surupa is one Brahma Masmiti Vibhavayantaha, the one all in the Bhavata Aham Brahma Asmi, we discussed in the last verse. This is the Jnane Vibhavayantaha. One dates in that kind of bhavana. Vikshari Brahmanta, the one who may be wandering free, the other ones residing under a tree, but still, Kaupi Topi Kalu Bhagyavantaha, one is blessed indeed. All these things. That how life is. Not like it is beast and what it is, how a life of sadhu is obviously all life is a holiday for Swami. It's nothing against the person. The person is completely free because Vedanta Jnana. Life is sadhu life and nation of Asadana of Puji Swamiji, we thought it apt to actually these called Sadhana Vanchak Kaupeena Panchakam and pay our obeisance to Swamiji. The Guru Radhikam Tapaha Guru Paradharamasti Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. Om Purnamidam Purnamidam Purnat Purnachare Purnasamadaya Purnameva Vasishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha.